So imagine you're the House Republican caucus, and after the last election, you have to deal with a 40-something president who's been elected, and you're having to recover from a lot of losses. And so they've elected a leadership team that includes a couple of 40-something leaders, Minority Whip Eric Cantor, who's from the Richmond area in Virginia, and the GOP conference chairman, Mike Pence, who's from a rural area in Indiana. And they're both very staunch conservatives, and they're trying to come up with basically a new message, but also a new face for their party as they're trying to prepare for the midterm election in 2010.
Our members are still committed to a stimulus bill that will actually preserve, protect, and create jobs.
With the stimulus bill, of course, we really saw Cantor and Pence working as a team to basically provide a, I think, an alternative message to what was being provided by President Obama and other supporters of the stimulus. And so they were both trying to appeal to younger voters, from college students as well as parents with younger children, talking about the impact of what they portrayed as a big spending bill on the debt.
If you look at the future of this country, obviously it resides in the hands of the youth. And we as a party need to do a much better job at putting our vision out there and making sure that it connects with the reality of the challenges that people face.
The president has struck a resonant chord with millions of younger Americans. But as I was speaking to a classroom full of ninth graders in Columbus, Indiana on Monday, when you play it straight with these kids and you let them know that all this spending in Washington, D.C., that they're going to get the tab, they get that, they understand that, and they appreciate people that are willing to come in and be real with them.
I think one of the tests will be whether Cantor and Eric Cantor and his counterpart Mike Pence, whether they can actually not only oppose bills, but maybe reach agreement on some things. And I think reaching agreement on some things could be difficult. It might put them at odds with the right wing of their party. And that's one of the things I think we'll be looking for as we go forward on issues such as education and health care, how much leeway they have to move to the center.